Hi, this is Pushkar. This video is about the stock price prediction and forecasting using long short-term memory. Here, we will be considering one company's stock price and we will try to see whether we are able to do the prediction and the forecasting by using the LSTM model. Now here, I am having already imported some packages that we will be needing. Here, this four line of code, we use the symbol to obtain of all the information downloaded that is available in Yahoo Finance for this stock from 1st January 2018 to 31st December 2020. Here we can see the data. We are able to see a lot of features like date, open, high, low, close, activity close and volumes. This line of code visualizes the data. Here I am using the highest price of column to visualizing the data. Now here I am creating the new data frame with only the closing price column and date will be the index column. Here I am converting this data frame to NumPy array. So I am create a variable train underscore dataset equals to new underscore data dot values. Now here I am applying the min max scalar. LSTM are very much sensitive to the scale data. Now in this particular data the value is not some kind of scale, so we should always try to transform this particular value. In this particular example we are going to take a min max scalar where we will be transforming our values between 0 and 1. For this I am going to import min max scalar. In the min max scalar, I am going to take a feature range between 0 and 1. This is the value that you need to give when you want to scale down between 0 and 1. Now after executing the cell, you will be able to see your scale data will be now converted into an array and it's now having value between 0 and 1. Here we are going to convert the data into X train and Y train. This line of code will be indexed from position 0 to position 59 and the Y train dataset first pass through will contain the 61st values which will be at position 60. I am converting X train and Y train data into NumPy arrays. Now here I am going to convert X train and Y train data to a NumPy arrays. Here I am reshaping the data because right now our X train dataset is a two-dimensional form and LSTM network expects the input data to be a three-dimensional form. So that's why I am reshaping the data. Here I am creating a LSTM network model. We will be using a sequential model first. In the first layer, I am adding the 50 hidden neurons. Return sequence equals to true and provide the input shape values. I am adding one more layer of LSTM. In this, here also I am giving 50 hidden neurons. At last, finally, I have added one final output. Now here I am compiling the model with the help of mean squared error and optimizer's Adam. Here I have just fit X train and Y train. Epoch I am considering 5 and batch size is 1, verbose is 2. Here we can see the loss is continuous decreasing. Here we can see the loss value is continuous decreasing. Now here I am downloading the 1 month stock market data of Tech Mahindra from 1st January 2021 to 31st January 2021. Here we can see a open price value of Tech Mahindra and for this particular price we will be doing the stock prediction. Here I am creating the data frame and I am to take this open column. And for this particular price, we'll be doing the stock prediction. Here I am testing data in a new data frame. So I have concatenated the only open column and then extract 80 records stored in the variable and then reshape this data. X test dataset contained past 60 values. Again, we are converting to 8 NumPy arrays so that we can use in the LSTM model. Here, I am again reshaping the data because our dataset is 2-dimensional and we need to be 3-dimensional because the LSTM model expecting a 3-dimensional shape. Here, I am created a variable called predicted stock price and I am going to set is equal to model and we are giving the X test values. This line of code inverse the transform the data of predicted stock price. Here we can see the real stock price and predicted stock price. See the graph. We can see here in blue line indicate the predicted stock price and red line indicate real stock price. So we can see in the graph the model is not exactly predicted, but we can say model the prediction.